Association banned the school's basketball team from the postseason.
Yeah, initial reports were pretty disturbing in terms of the allegations. The district now says their coach signed a check for a player from the Congo, and they say he did that to protect the player.
But the IHSAA says what the school did was an egregious violation. Tonight, Fox 59's Kelly Rinke shows us how we got to this point.
In more than 20 pages, Perry Township Schools laid out their reasons for appealing the IHSAA's decision to ban the basketball team from the state tournament. IHSAA says the school's violation is obvious. However, the school district says the situation is more complex.
My hope is that human decency comes into play here and people understand that this was done, even if it wasn't done correctly, was done for the right reasons.
Today, basketball coach Eric Brand explained why he signed a more than $5,000 check for a student athlete.
I thought maybe he's worried about he's going to be deported. Somebody from immigration is going to take him. And I just wanted to give him a stable environment.
The school says a man brought a 15-year-old student from the Congo to play basketball in the U.S. and that the man tried to get the student on an F-1 student visa. Southport says the man failed to pay the required reimbursement and eventually abandoned the teen in Perry Township. Coach Brand says a basketball boosters nonprofit that he is in charge of raised enough money to pay for the student's F-1 visa status and signed the check.
I felt like if I raised the money and the fact that this young man could not this year play varsity basketball, I still don't understand why we're being punished.
The district says the student was never going to be on the varsity team this year because they do not grant that to students with F-1 visas. So the school says Coach Brand did not benefit by signing the check. IHSAA sees it differently, saying this was tied to recruiting.
This is overreaching by the coach. This is manipulation by the coach.
Bobby Cox with IHSAA says the man who brought the student to the U.S. reported the incident to the association. Cox says they gave Perry Township time to investigate. When the district said they would suspend Coach Brand for 2 games, Cox says that was not enough.
This is an egregious violation. This is one of the worst things that can happen in amateur sports, is when a coach, through a booster club, pays the tuition of a student to attend his school for the purposes of playing basketball.
The school says it was trying to support a teen in crisis. Coach Brand believes this punishment is unfair to his varsity team.
They've worked really hard the last 2 years, but I've had them.
In Indianapolis, I'm Kelly Rinke, Fox 59 News.
Now, the student still goes to school at Southport and is staying with a teacher and his wife. The appeal hearing is set for next Wednesday. We'll continue to follow the investigation and let you know what happens. Stick with Fox 59 for further updates on air and online at fox59.com.
We are also keeping a close eye on developing news. This out of